Hello everyone, and welcome to part 4 of our racing game tutorial. Today we are going to round off our track generation code. We introduced a number of script variables in our previous video. We are going to add code that adjusts the track when these variables are changed. We start by updating the position of our rails based on our track width and post distance settings. To make this work, we need to update the polygon input of our CSG polygon for each of our rails. Bear with me for a moment while I write the code that sets each point for our polygon. This does get a little tedious, as I'm just copying the coordinates originally set for our polygon, but using a variable input together with the offsets to calculate our x values. Switching to our 3D editor view, we can now see that adjusting the track width nicely moves our left barrier into position. For our right barrier, only our original code positioning our posts works. So we now need to do the same for our right barrier. We copy the code we wrote for our left barrier and adjust our values. Now both barriers move properly when we change the width of our road. To change the width of our track, we apply the same trick. We only have 4 vertices to adjust this time. Our track now sizes properly as well. Time to move on to the ground. For the ground, we first need to add another property that allows us to change the lower width. We add the property and just duplicate the code for our track width. This is starting to get very repetitive, but yes, we perform the exact same technique on the ground mesh, but use our new property for the lower vertices. And there we go. The last mesh we need to change is our collision shape. Our track was a very simple example of how we can make procedural logic to building assets. With more time and more effort, we could create a really nice environment for our racing game. This last step is, however, pretty tedious, and as I was building the first version of this some weeks ago, I wondered if there was a better option. My previous video showed an example of an alternative method where we use a visual graph to create a complex mesh. This new module is still a work in progress, and there are still missing parts and a few problems left to solve before it is good enough to use for my racing game. I did want to show a preview of this approach, so the last minute of this video I'll show a time lapse of rebuilding the track using the new logic, faults and all. This is sped up a fair bit with a few trial and error moments edited out. It took me roughly 45 minutes to build. So that's it for this video. I'm planning to work some more on perfecting the procedural mesh logic and then do a proper tutorial video on how it actually works. I'm also planning on doing another video in the shader series. That will likely be my next video. It may thus be a few weeks before I do the next video on the racing game. I'm thinking about doing a side episode showing how to add a VR mode for the game. In the next episode for the series, however, we'll start to look at improving the car's handling and controls. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to our channel if you're interested in more. It would also really help me if you hit that like button. Enjoy the rest of the time lapse. Until next time.